Hi, my name is Johnny Blade. Well, at least that was the name I used when I worked as an on-air personality in radio. My real name is Rob, and between 1986 and 2000, I worked at a number of different radio stations as an on-air personality, which included voicing commercial spots. I worked at three different television stations during that time. I was a director. I wrote, produced, directed, and voiced many commercial and public service announcements. I was also involved in the creation of logos and editing. I graduated from Brown Institute in Minneapolis, Minnesota, with a degree in radio and television broadcast. I have worked under a number of different radio formats, including classic rock, top 40, country, adult contemporary, and 50s and 60s oldies. Last year, I published a book called Elvis From One Fan to Another. It's an interactive Elvis book, the first of its kind. In order to view the book, go to the website that's listed below, which is www.elvisfromonefantoanother.com. My first passion is music. That was the reason I got involved in broadcasting to begin with. This series is called Musical Notes, and it gives me an opportunity to share musical appreciation with other music lovers, such as yourself. The first installment of this series will deal with the origins of rock and roll. So please follow along. If you have any comments or questions, please contact me via YouTube or the website www.elvisfromonefantoanother.com. You could say that rock and roll was four decades in the making. The term rockin' and rollin' was first used by Marines in the 1800s to describe the constant shifting of a ship on the ocean. However, by the early 1900s, this had become a euphemism used by African-American gospel bands to describe the spiritual fervor that came over someone when possessed by the Holy Spirit. This religious use of the term would become very important by the early 50s, because Elvis Presley would unite rhythm and blues music with gospel music. One of the earliest known recordings to use the phrase rockin' was a 1904 Victor phonograph record called The Camp Meeting Jubilee by the Hayden Quartet. It contained the words, "We've been rockin' and rollin' in your arms, in the arms of Moses." Another version of the song was issued on the Little Wonder record label in 1916. Rockin' was also used to describe the spiritual rapture felt by worshipers at certain religious events and to refer to the rhythm often found in the accompanying music. Here is the Little Wonder version of The Camp Meeting Jubilee from 1916. By the early 1900s, the Emancipation Proclamation had set most African Americans free, and while segregation and racism were still very high, the freedom African Americans found allowed them to build their own towns and cities where African Americans could form communities. It took no time for the African American community to mold their own musical styles together. The African American community was filled with talented instrument players, and while they adopted ragtime and swing music from their white counterparts, the old style of African American music known as blues had been handed down. Blues was simple in its arrangement, usually only having one or two guitars and one singer. The lyrics were always depressing and illustrated the day-to-day grind that both African American men and women went through. It was not unusual for a female to sing the blues about that no-good man of hers. The blues would impact rock and roll in a huge way.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
The most famous blues artist is probably Robert Johnson. Many consider him the father of blues. Robert only lived 27 years and was rumored to have made a deal with the devil in which the devil gave Robert the ability to create music never before heard, and Robert would give the devil his soul in return. The song Crossroads was written about this mythical transaction. Here's a sample of Robert's music. To find out more about Robert Johnson, be sure to see my musical notes on blues. In the early 1930s, a fast rhythm bass piano style called Boogie Woogie was the rage in the African American community around the country. By this time, the phrase rock and roll was increasingly being used as a secular black slang with a double meaning, ostensibly referring to dancing and partying, but then also subtly talking about the act of sex. When this fast rhythm was mixed with blues, it created a new sound that was coined rhythm and blues, which dominated black radio in the 1940s and early 50s. It was at this point that young white Americans began to take notice of this fascinating sound that had been almost exclusive to the African American community. While rhythm and blues had been specifically marketed to young African Americans, young white teenagers all over America had become captivated by this unusual style of music. In 1951, a white Cleveland-based disc jockey on WJW named Alan Freed began to introduce this style publicly to the white audience. Alan Freed was the first to coin the phrase rock and roll. While this term was a description of the sexual act in the African American community, Alan was the first to link it to music. Little did Alan know, he was about to become the most famous disc jockey in rock and roll history.
Hello everybody, hi all tonight. This is Alan Freed, the old king of the Moondoggers, and it's time again for another of your favorite rock and roll sessions, blues and rhythm records for all the gang in the Moondog Kingdom, from the Midwest to the East Coast. We're going to be saying hello to a lot of folks who've written to us tonight from all over the Moondog Kingdom, all around the Cleveland area, Newark, New Jersey, New York City, Long Island, wherever you are. And I hope you folks have a good supply of good old Aaron Brew on hand. It's the greatest beer of them all, Northern Ohio's largest selling beer, and it's perfectly balanced for good taste and flavor. So enjoy Aaron Brew as you enjoy the Moondog Show.
Various recordings dating back to the late 1940s have been put forward as the first rock and roll song, a song with a true rock and roll sound. However, narrowing this down to one specific song is harder than you might think. For example, in 1922, a female blues singer named Trixie Smith recorded a song called My Man Rocks Me with One Steady Roll. There can be little doubt as to what Trixie was referring to when she talks about rockin'.
My man rocks me with one steady roll.
Before 1950, African American music was often referred to as race records. But the material was so good, even the likes of Benny Goodman and the Dorsey Brothers would cover these songs from time to time. Deep racism and ethnic hatred effectively stopped black artists from crossing over into a white audience in the 1930s and 40s, but change was in the air. One early use of the word rock in describing a style of music was in a review in Metronome magazine, July 21, 1938, which stated, and I quote, "Harry James's Lullaby and Rhythm really rocks. While there might be disagreement among historians, the most probable candidate as the first real rock and roll record, the one that has the rock and roll sound we've come to know, is probably Roy Brown's Good Rockin' Tonight. The song encapsulated the steady rhythm with lyrics that had an obvious sexual meaning. Elvis Presley would propel this song to legendary heights when he recorded it in 1954. It was the second single Presley would release on the Sun Records label. Here is Roy Brown's version of Good Rockin' Tonight.
Well, I heard the news about Good Rockin' Tonight. Well, I'm gonna hold my baby tight as I can. Tonight she'll know I'm a mighty, mighty man. I heard the news. Good rockin' tonight. Oh yes, I heard the news. Good rockin' tonight. Well, I'm gonna hold my baby tight as I can. Tonight she'll know I'm a mighty, mighty man. I heard the news. Good rockin' tonight. Well, meet me in a hurry behind the bar. Don't be afraid. I want you to bring my rocking shoes, cause tonight I'm gonna rock away all my blues. I heard the news, there's good rockin' tonight.
It is my personal opinion that the first true rock and roll song was a tune called 60 Minute Man by Billy Ward and the Dominoes, released in 1951. I rock 'em and roll 'em all night long is the steady refrain in this timeless classic. Let's take a listen to 60 Minute Man by Billy Ward and the Dominoes.
Telling you now, they call me Love and Dad. I'll rock 'em, roll 'em all night long. I'm a 60-minute man.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you don't believe I'm all I say, come up and take my hand. When I let you go, you'll cry. Oh yes, he's a 60-minute man. There'll be 15 minutes of kissing. Then you holler, please don't stop.
Don't stop.
There'll be 50 minutes teasing and 50 minutes squeezing and 50 minutes of blowing my top.
Mop, mop, mop.
If your man ain't treating you right, come up and see your dad. I'll rock 'em, roll 'em all night long. I'm a 60-minute man.
60-minute
man.
Call in.
Love and then I'll rock, roll all night long. I'm a
60-minute man.
60-minute
man.
They call me.
Man.
There'll be 15 minutes of kissing. Then you holler, please don't stop.
Don't stop.
There'll be 50 minutes of teasing, and 50 minutes of squeezing, and 50 minutes of blowing my top. If your man ain't treating you right, come up and see old Dan. I'll rock 'em, roll 'em all night long. I'm a 60-minute man, oh yeah.
60-minute man.
Another contender for first ever rock and roll song is Rocket 88, released on Chess Records in 1951 by the would-be future megastar Ike Turner. Ike used the money he made off sales of Rocket 88 to finance more of his music career, including his discovery and later marriage to Tina Turner. By the late 1960s, Ike and Tina Turner would be a major Las Vegas act, but this is a story for another segment of Musical Notes. Listen to Rocket 88 by Ike Turner.
You women have heard of jalopies, you've heard the noise they make, but let me introduce my new Rocket 88. Yes, it's straight, just one way. Everybody likes my Rocket 88. Baby, we'll ride in style, moving all along. Is smart and designed, black convertible top, and the gals don't mind sporting with me, riding all around town for joy. Blow your horn, Raymond, blow! In my rocket and don't be late, baby, we're pulling out about 8:30. Going round the corner and hit a bill. Everybody in my car's gonna take a little nip. Move on out, oozing and cruising along.
Musicians like Elvis Presley, Buddy Holly, Roy Orbison, Johnny Cash, and Jerry Lee Lewis were avid fans of this evolving new sound called rock and roll. The first two albums that Elvis Presley released were primarily filled with rhythm and blues songs that had been written and performed by African-American artists. Here's a sample of some of the material from those albums.
Ready, set, go, man, go. I got a gal that I love so I'm ready. Ready, 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 ready to rock and roll. Going down to the corner, pick up my sweetie pie. She's a rock and roll baby, she's apple of my eye. Ready, 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 I'm ready. Rock and roll out of flat top cats and the dungaree dog. I headed for the gym to the sock hop ball. The joints really jumping, the cats are going wild. I'm usually really some my daddy Prince Brown. Ready, ready, ready. Well, it's Saturday night and I just got paid. I fool about my money, don't try to save. My heart says go, go, have a time. It's Saturday night, baby, and I'm feeling fine. I wanna rock it out. I wanna rip it out. I wanna shake it out. I'm gonna ball it up. I'm gonna rip it up. Having a ballin' night. Well, I got me a date and I won't be late. I picked her up in my 88. Shag on down by the social hall. When the joint starts jumping, I'll have a ball. I'm gonna rock it up. Wop, bop, a loo, wop, lop, bam, boom. Tutti frutti, oh Rudy. 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 Wop, bop, a loo, wop, lop, bam, boom. I got a gal named Sue. She know just what to do. I got a gal named Sue. She know just what to do. She rock me to the east, she rock me to the west. She's a gal that I love best. Tutti frutti, oh Rudy. Something I done, something that she heard. My baby left me, my baby left me. My baby even left me, never said a word. Lord, I stand at my window, wring my hands and cry. I hate to lose that woman, hate to say goodbye. You know she left me, yes, yeah, she left me. My baby even left me.
I want to thank you for taking the time to listen to this presentation. If you have comments or questions, please feel free to contact me on the YouTube message boards or go to the website www.elvisfromonefantoanother.com. This is Johnny Blade saying stay sharp, and I look forward to seeing you next time.